Welcome, everyone. I hope you're in good health and good spirits. I'd like to thank you for taking time out of your day to join this webinar on improving infrastructure resilience. Our country's infrastructure is desperately in need of investment. The American Society of Civil Engineers, ASCE, released their quadrennial infrastructure report card earlier in 2021 and gave the United States infrastructure an overall grade of C-. While this is a minor improvement over the 2017's dismal D-plus grade, there's much work to be done, as 11 of 17 categories are still in the D range, with elements approaching the end of their service life and exhibiting significant deterioration. The ASCE estimates that the U.S. will need to spend multiple trillions of dollars by 2025 to fix the country's roads, bridges, dams, and other infrastructure. And President Biden has already proposed a $2 trillion infrastructure plan. Similar degradation of infrastructure and the corresponding big repair bills can be seen all across our international network, from Latin America to Europe to Asia Pacific to SADC in Western Africa to the Middle East. Infrastructure development for highways and road corridors faces many challenges when it comes to project design and construction. Building asphalt or concrete roadways over soft soils requires thick base layers of expensive stone and pavement surfaces, and these often fail just a few years after installation. Expanding road width requires steepening corridor embankments, leading to potential slope failure that can cause road closures and damage. Stormwater management along roads is an increasingly common concern due to limited construction space and larger storm events. Presto Geosystems provides cost-effective, low-maintenance, quality solutions for all of these potential issues using our GEOWEB 3D Soil Stabilization System. In this webinar, we'll discuss how to utilize these solutions to address the challenges of aging infrastructure. I'm your host, Jose Pablo George, or JP, the International Business Development Manager with Presto Geosystems. We manufacture industry-leading erosion control, stormwater management, and porous pavement products, all made in the upper Midwest of the United States. Through an extensive national and international distribution network, we offer technical and site support, as well as free project evaluation from our in-house design engineering team. Today's presentation of improving infrastructure resilience will focus on permanent stabilization solutions for better roads, highways, and bridges with GEOWEB geocells. Here are the things I hope you get out of today's presentation. Understand how our products can provide permanent solutions in building roads as well as along roadways. Understand how geocells work in challenging soil environments. Learn about the different applications where geocells can be used in road building. Learn how they can help manage stormwater and stabilize slopes and right-of-ways. And learn how geocells can prolong your pavement life. First, a little background on Presto. We worked with the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers to develop geocell technology in the late 70s and have been innovating ever since. Our products have been used in over 200 countries and in every state of the U.S. We go beyond simply providing a product to helping you provide a complete stabilization solution. We operate in three product areas: soil stabilization using our GEOWEB geocells, which can be used for load support, slope, and channel protection, and constructing green retaining walls. Porous pavements, of which we have both vegetated and aggregate solutions, and lightweight reusable construction mats. Today's presentation will focus mainly on GEOWEB geocells. We'll now get into a little general information about GEOWEB geocells. The GEOWEB system is our version of GeoCell technology and consists of two main attributes. The first is the cell or container size. The cells come in three diameters, small, medium, and large, with varying cell heights. These dimensions depend on project details and vehicle loading requirements, and we can help you determine which is the best for your specific project. The ultrasonically welded seam, where all the connecting points are, is very important to the function of a geocell. The stronger the seam strength, the better the performance of the geocell will be. A strong seam allows for heavier infill, steeper and taller slopes, and better lifetime performance. GEOWEB is produced using high-quality virgin high-density polyethylene resin for consistently strong welds at cell junctions, while also maintaining semi-rigid ductile properties within the cell walls, high stress crack resistance, and overall toughness and long-term durability in the environment. Our geocells do not use fillers or exotic polymer alloy blends, which can ultimately reduce weld strength and environmental stress crack resistance, and that are offered in some competing products in the name of increasing cell wall stiffness. To avoid weld failures and the damaging effects of differential settlement, uniformity in performance across all elements of a geocell system is much more important than stiffness alone. Here we see a typical GEOWEB panel. It comes trifolded on a pallet. Each section has a nominal width of 8.5 feet with lengths up to 58 feet. The panels are flexible, opening like an accordion, so they can follow the natural contours of the worksite without being confined to a rigid set of dimensions. The second main attribute of the GEOWEB system is the infill, or what you put into the container. An important benefit of the GEOWEB system is that even a low-quality aggregate, sand, or a certain salvage material can be used to infill the cells. Using salvaged aggregate or sand can save significant amounts of money on material and hauling costs. We can also eliminate fines when desired, since the cells provide the confinement and aid compaction of cohesionless soils. Without fines, you can significantly improve drainage and let the water flow freely through the system, preventing pore pressure buildup and global failure of the cross-section. The ability to use sands and low-quality aggregates really sets the 3D GEOWEB system apart from planar geogrids and other geotextiles. Those products typically require high-quality materials with high friction angles to achieve their optimal performance. With the GEOWEB system, low-friction angle materials are just fine, as the panels achieve their full potential even with these poor quality materials, which can result in huge cost savings for you. The system components are all the supporting pieces that help GEOWEB protect the road surface and sub-base layers, and also ensure relatively uniform performance of the interconnected system, thereby protecting against the damaging effects of non-uniform deformation and differential settlement in response to applied loads. Presto's GEOWEB is equipped with numerous design and construction components that increase strength and speed of installation. The Etrakey is the first component for a completely integrated system, connecting each individual panel of GEOWEB into a single web that covers the slope, channel, or roadway. It allows for faster installation of the GEOWEB and will last the lifetime of the project. The specific engineering values of the Etrakey will ensure the system holds up to the loading over time without corrosion as seen in staples or the failure of underperforming cable tie systems. Our spec sheet calls out the specific engineering values for this patented connector. As slope angles increase, the driving force of the infill material exceeds the available frictional resisting force, and additional anchorage is required. Atra anchors hold the GEOWEB to the slope and penetrate into the ground. If corrosion resistance is required due to project conditions, Presto has an HDPE Atra speed stake designed to work specifically with GEOWEB, and offers more resistance to extraction compared to rebar. For steep slopes, a slope where native soil is highly erodible, or over a surface that cannot be punctured, such as a geomembrane liner, tendons can be used. The Atra tendon clips transfer the load from heavy infill materials to the tendons and crest anchorage system. Only the Atra tendon clip is specifically designed to fully transfer, safely and securely, the forces placed upon the system. Every accessory and every feature has been designed and tested to specifically work together. So we go from problem to design to construction solution with a system where the modeling replicates the real world forces. In order for a geocell system to perform uniformly, it is critical that both the factory welded junctions or internal junctions and the field joint junctions, mechanical junctions, perform at a level that's commensurate with that of the cell walls. For most typical sites, GEOWEB will retain its durability for greater than 50 years, with lab testing indicating 149 years without degradation, even at full exposure to elements. We stand behind our numbers, so you can deliver certainty in the solution as you build with materials you can trust. We'll now move on to discuss our soil stabilization capabilities using GEOWEB cellular confinement systems as they relate to roads and highways. Presto offers solutions for many different road and highway applications. Load support for unpaved roads, road shoulders, and base stabilization under paved surfaces. Slope stabilization, encompassing embankment slopes, bridge abutments, and retaining walls. And stormwater control through roadside ditches, drainage channels, and culvert outfalls. The purpose of cellular confinement is very simple. Stabilize the movement of unstable soils, both horizontally and vertically. The weaker the subgrade conditions, the more practical the insertion of the GEOWEB system into the design. It's an engineered system integrating multiple types of geosynthetics with the best method of confinement and subgrade stress reduction in the industry. Although today's discussion will focus on the GEOWEB system for roadway infrastructure, other applications include intermodal, rail ballast reinforcement, steepened slopes, vegetated swales, lined channels, and vertical MSE wells. For more information on these specific applications, please see our website, prestogeo.com. The GEOWEB 3D system works in this way. When a vertical load is applied, the active earth pressure in the loaded cell pushes back against the passive earth pressure in the adjacent cell to form a stable system. Being confined, the soil responds passively. The soil is limited in its movements, represented by the yellow arrows. The cells adjacent to the loaded cell provide passive resistance, as shown in the diagram by the red arrows. The load is dispersed over a greater area in the lower layers as each cell helps support the ones around it. The GEOWEB cell walls also transfer hoop stress, which is important in keeping the system intact and creates a mattress effect. The strength of the seams around each cell, the material properties of the individual strips, and the connection method between panels are all important factors in determining how the geocell system can improve load-bearing capacity. Strong seams, semiductile resin properties, and these integrated connections are critical to a well-performing system. The GEOWEB system and its accessories are specifically designed to work together to be an effective, permanent solution for roads in soft soil locations. In a load support scenario, vertical deformation can only occur with either compression and compaction of the soils or through lateral movement of soil particles. By spreading out the load in a classic granular fill approach, one can reduce compaction of near surface soils. But only with cellular confinement can one assure no lateral shifting occurs, which leads to rutting. This mattress effect reduces the stress reaching the subgrade. And here we can see that represented. We see the stresses on the subgrade with an unsupported subgrade on the left and with GeoWeb reinforcement on the right. Notice how there's a complete elimination of the highest stresses at the surface when using GeoWeb reinforcement. When the stresses are reduced and distributed over a wider area, this is the mattress effect and can lead to a significant decrease in deflection and rutting. By eliminating that lateral particle movement, GeoWeb helps stabilize the surface, eliminating the need for constant maintenance. Here we see the impressive load support benefits of an 80,000-pound loaded dump truck, or standard H2H25 loading parameters, on a partially filled GeoWeb panel over a soft subgrade. We see how the cells push back against each other to help support this load, and only the adjacent cells need to be filled for the support. The GeoWeb system is often compared to 2D geogrids, and they do start with a similar concept. However, due to the 3D nature of GeoWeb, the integrated infill geosynthetic system acts as a composite layer where lateral earth pressures are mobilized and transferred across the three-dimensional network of interconnected cells. This is the mattress effect I mentioned earlier. Because of this phenomenon, lower quality fill materials, often sand or other fill readily available on site, can be beneficially reused, thereby eliminating the need to import expensive aggregate as required often with geogrids. The GeoWeb system uses a thinner cross-section as well. A 6-inch GeoWeb system is equivalent to a 12-inch geogrid section, often requiring two or more layers of geogrid. We can also eliminate fines when desired, since the cells provide the confinement and aid compaction of cohesionless soils. Without fines, we can significantly improve drainage and let the water flow freely through the cross-section, preventing the pore pressure buildup and global failure. Additionally, geogrids do little to stabilize the surface, requiring significantly more maintenance long-term, since the aggregate is loose at the surface and can get pushed around by vehicle passes. Continuing on with the theme of unpaved gravel surface road application, a washed or clear stone can be used in the GeoWeb system, allowing you to build stable, permeable, low-impact development access roads. Site access roads, both temporary and permanent, are a very common application for the GeoWeb system. As mentioned, heavy loaded vehicles can drive on the system immediately after infilling to help finish construction. This is a huge construction time saver. With GeoWeb panels and a woven geotextile, you can bridge soft, wet ground, creating access roads with little to no site disturbance. Saturated soils typically cannot support any type of vehicle loading. Woven geotextiles can add an additional strength layer to the system and won't get clogged by subgrade materials while still allowing water movement as necessary. A clearstone infill combined with perforations in the GeoWeb cell walls allows water to flow both vertically and laterally through the system, limiting impact in sensitive environmental locations in ways that paved asphalt or concrete roads cannot. The GeoWeb system can support all highway traffic loading, making it a great option for extending shoulder areas along roadways. The GeoWeb panels can be filled with either aggregate or an engineered fill, two parts aggregate, one part topsoil, that allows for full vegetation growth while at the same time supporting vehicle loading. Both infill types can widen roads for emergency access and can help manage stormwater runoff from the impervious asphalt pavement by allowing the stormwater to infiltrate and reducing erosion concerns at the pavement edges. Building on that thought of stormwater infiltration, I'll point out that the GEOWEB system can create true porous pavement. The water infiltrates at the point of impact, reducing surface runoff and reducing or potentially eliminating the need for additional stormwater infrastructure, such as detention ponds. In this regard, porous pavements offer several regulatory advantages, and we have a lot of material like that on our website and can support your project through the permitting and design phase. Reach out to one of our in-house engineers or see prestogeo.com for more information. We're now going to switch from using the GEOWEB system as the road surface to using the system for road base stabilization and helping extend your pavement life. The GEOWEB system can be used in place of or in conjunction with the traditional aggregate layer beneath a paved asphalt or concrete road surface. The same mattress effect from the GEOWEB panels that we just discussed still applies here, with the system helping bridge soft soils and adding strength to weak subgrades. When used as a base layer, those stiffening effects of a uniform system are translated up through the surface layer, keeping the paved surface stable and in place, and reducing maintenance requirements. Plus, the GEOWEB system can allow for a thinner cross-section, up to about 50 to 70% thinner, which means there's going to be less excavation required on site. This is a great benefit when you have shallow public utilities, like the project shown here in Ohio. Note how the asphalt layer can go down as soon as the GEOWEB is filled. No need for cure time or special equipment. Again, the ability to use low quality aggregate or granular material is huge, meaning you can use on-site or salvage materials without needing expensive, difficult to obtain engineered stone. The stress reduction capacity of the panels will reduce the potential for deformation or settlement when placed over soft soils, which means you won't see the alligator cracking and wheel ruts forming at the surface. A stronger base layer means a stronger surface layer and longer pavement lifetimes with less maintenance and section replacement. Here's a common project we see. I'm sure we've all dealt with roads like the one in the upper left, surface cracking, ruts, lots of patched areas that seem to start failing almost immediately. That's what happens when the road is built over a weak base layer that cannot fully support vehicle traffic. With the GEOWEB system, the failed asphalt and base layers are removed, the panels laid down and filled with granular material, and then a fresh paved surface is placed over the panels. Now we have a strong base, leading to a strong surface that will look cleaner and last much longer with much less patching and maintenance required. The GEOWEB system can be used under all types of roadways, from private drives to full service highways. Like this project for the New Mexico State Highway and Transportation Department. Unable to proceed on a timely basis with any of the conventional alternatives, such as deep excavation with thick base layers or using chemical stabilizers on the extremely soft subgrade, the DOT turned to the Presto GEOWEB system. Local sand was used as the infill material with a 6-inch deep GEOWEB system under the asphalt pavement. Nearly 200,000 square feet of GEOWEB panels went into the ground quickly and inexpensively, solving the DOT's budget and construction issues. The GEOWEB GRC is an application of GEOWEB for rigid pavements with thicknesses of 3 to 4 inches of concrete acting in a monolithic way. GRC allows for the construction of fast installation concrete roadways with typical yields of 6,500 square feet per day per work group. As shown before in the diagram with yellow and red arrows, the cells surrounding the loaded geocell help support and disperse the stresses of the load. Here we see the GRC system in action under heavy loading. No expansion joints needed, unlike traditional concrete slabs. GRC has small shrinkage gaps between the GEOWEB cell wall and the cured concrete, providing control joints on the perimeter of the cell walls. GEOWEB GRC allows pores in irregular shapes and to suspend and renew pores when and where required. Here's a summary of the construction process for GEOWEB reinforced concrete pavement. The innovative GEOWEB GRC system was developed for use as an industrial pavement solution, as seen in this multimodal center. GRC pavements offer an economic, long-lasting industrial pavement option with thinner cross-sections compared to traditional pavements. The GRC system is perfect for secondary and residential roadways, like this example from Baru in Colombia. 5 miles of roadways with 3-inch GEOWEB. And here are the GRC roads after installation. In this example, in the Carolina area of Cartagena, GRC was used as the roadway, the gutters, and the stormwater channel, all as one monolithic structure able to resist high flow storm events. 2.5 miles of roadways and channels. The flexibility of the GEOWEB geocell reinforced concrete system allows for long-lasting economical solutions. The GRC pavement system was incorporated at Port Agua Dulce in Colombia as a hybrid base and surface stabilization system. Here's the installation of the GRC system and heavy vehicle traffic. GEOWEB reinforced concrete pavements are perfect as industrial pavements, like this distribution center. The subgrade here is pretty soft, 1 to 3% CBR. And here's an example of the base layer going down for the distribution center. And in these photos, a bit more of the installation process. And here's the final pavement with heavy loading GEOWEB for load support is the classic use, and the system has evolved since its original designation. We'll now move to embankment stabilization using GEOWEB geocells. Many times slopes and embankments need to be stabilized after or in conjunction with road and highway construction. The GEOWEB system for slopes can be filled with several different materials depending on your project needs. Topsoil with vegetation is the most common, but sometimes vegetation is not appropriate, so stone and concrete are also viable options. Here's a simplified diagram showing how the different system components interact with the GEOWEB to form a complete system. The first thing to go down is the geosynthetic underlayer, typically a planar geosynthetic material such as a geogrid or geotextile. Then the GEOWEB is put in place. Note how there's a horizontal turn near the top of the slope. This is important for crest anchorage and erosion control. There are several options for anchoring. One is using stakes with an atrus stake clip. These are placed mid-slope and at the crest. The number and spacing of stakes is project dependent. Another option is to use tendons and a dead man, with the dead man being a buried pipe, concrete anchor, or earth or rock anchors at the crest. The GEOWEB is then filled with the desired infill material and a vegetated, an erosion control blanket or hydro seeding used to prevent washout prior to vegetation. The GEOWEB works in multiple ways to protect the slope surfaces. It prevents significant movement of the soil by confining the soil to individual cells. By separating the soil into smaller segments, the system resists mobilization of the entire slope face due to hydraulic loading and prevents soil erosion. It's important to reiterate that proper installation of the GEOWEB includes embedding the GEOWEB in the crest of the slope. This prevents water from flowing beneath the system and undermining it. Also, no rills or gullies will form beneath GEOWEB and lead to failure. The GEOWEB system provides a way to fully vegetate slope surfaces that otherwise could not support sustainable plant life and increases the overall slope stability by interlocking with the vegetated root zone. Stone and concrete materials can also be confined within the GEOWEB panels, again on slopes that would normally be too steep to allow for natural stone slopes. Vegetated slopes are the most popular option because they can result in the most attractive slopes with little to no maintenance. It's important to note that the GEOWEB slope protection system is for surface erosion issues only. Because the GEOWEB panels are laid over the slope face, the system does not assist in globally stabilizing the slope. If that's a concern, other measures need to be taken, and we'll talk about options for that in a few minutes. If the slope is stable but seeing failure due to stormwater erosion or saturated soil movement, the GEOWEB slope protection system can help. Here's an example of a vegetated slope over an unstable soil slope at an active gold mine in Canada, with variable length slope and variable face angles. An access road was being built above the slope where you see the excavator, so the slope had to be stable enough to support expected live load traffic. Here we see space constraints at the toe of the slope in form of another access road, so the slope could not be regraded into a gentler slope. A nice feature of the GEOWEB slope system is shown in the after photo, where a guardrail is installed at the crest and a fence installed at the toe. There's no limit on this sort of infrastructure being installed near or on the GEOWEB panels, another great benefit for tight spaces like this one. This slope alongside a road in Ohio shows a common problem solved with the GEOWEB system. Erosion and washout of soil slopes under road surfaces is a problem in many locations. Covering the slope with a GEOWEB system and filling it with topsoil allows for a vegetated slope without the concern of having to constantly replace the soil after storm events. We recommend some sort of surface protection, such as hydroseeding or erosion control blankets, until vegetation has a chance to grow. Embankments along roadways have to deal with sheet flow runoff from the impervious surface, like the slope shown here for Maryland State Highway Administration project. The sheet flow can cause sloughing of large sections of the upper topsoil layer, causing deep rills and gullies and preventing vegetation from taking hold. The GEOWEB system holds the soil in place while allowing the water to run over the surface, so no more gullies and vegetation can form deep roots to further stabilize the slope. Road widening is becoming more common, with DOTs trying to find more roadway space without displacing any significant structures. The slopes or embankments are usually where that additional space can be found, as shown in this road widening project in New Hampshire. The GEOWEB slope protection system allowed for steeper slopes to be created without erosion concerns. The system can be installed quickly and vegetated quickly, so there's no long construction time to shut down important roadways. Ease and speed of construction are important features of the GEOWEB system that everyone appreciates. This project in Pennsylvania highlights a different issue I haven't mentioned so far, which is geomembrane liner protection. This highway cut exposed a pyrite-bearing sandstone to air and rain, creating the potential for acid rock drainage. To remediate, an impervious geomembrane was installed over the slope face, and then the GEOWEB system installed over the liner. The liner needs to be protected so it doesn't get punctured, which would allow air and water through, defeating its purpose. The GEOWEB system rests on top of the liner and is anchored with a tendon system without puncturing the liner, and the topsoil infill prevents damage to the liner over time. This is also a great way to cover landfills or protect drainage ponds that may have impervious liners to stop chemical or waste leaching. As I mentioned, GEOWEB protection can get very steep if needed. This was a project along the Pan American Highway in Peru, where the slope on each terrace was about 75 degrees. This was unique because these terraces were actually hand compacted to that angle, so not natural slopes. This project required tendons through every row of GEOWEB panels due to the steepness and weight of the infill. Earth anchors were used at the crest of each slope because a dead man trench wouldn't fit on the narrow terraces. They also chose to use a biaxial geogrid beneath the GEOWEB for additional soil control. And here's the final product. The vegetation has taken hold and the slopes are stable, even at such extreme angles. Aggregate infill can provide a low maintenance solution, great for areas where vegetation may not grow easily or where stone is more common. Aggregate infill allows for water infiltration, so it can collect runoff from road surfaces and be kept clean fairly easily. The Minnesota Department of Transportation used the GEOWEB system to help stabilize the surface around bridge abutments and along railroad tracks and crossings. The flexible nature of the GEOWEB panels means it can easily contour to the slope face and around obstacles such as piles and abutments. With the system in place, Water erosion is prevented around abutments, reducing maintenance costs. The project was a mix of topsoil and vegetation and aggregate infills, with aggregate being used below the bridges where vegetation would have been difficult to establish. Concrete infill for slopes is our last main infill type. The system would no longer be considered permeable, but there are no maintenance requirements, and embankments can handle significant amounts of stormwater runoff if needed. The GEOWEB panels act as the formwork for the concrete and as the internal reinforcement, so no forms or rebar are required. The concrete is poured directly into the GEOWEB panels and screeded to the top of the cell walls, ensuring a consistent concrete depth without it slumping to the toe of the slope. Concrete-filled GEOWEB or hard armor slopes are best used when there's going to be heavy water flow. Here's a slope and channel project that takes water runoff from a train intermodal yard. The GEOWEB system replaced a design that had 6-inch reinforced concrete channels and 4-inch deep grout bag slope protection. The GEOWEB was a value engineering solution due to cost overruns. Using GEOWEB saved the owner a couple million of dollars, but more importantly, it sped up construction and allowed the yard to be in service much quicker than originally planned. The side slopes of the channel used 3-inch deep GEOWEB, anchored with stakes because the slopes were short and relatively flat. The bottom of the channel used 4-inch deep GEOWEB so it could support vehicle access loads. This is another way the flexibility and versatility of the GEOWEB system can be used to create the right solution for your project requirements. The GEOWEB panels act as the form for concrete, so there's no need for additional formwork to be built, which can be tricky on slopes and in any event extends construction time. The concrete is poured from the top to the bottom, and cells hold the concrete in place and prevent it all from slumping and creating areas of uneven thickness. An advantage of GEOWEB is that it assures consistent placement thickness. Pore pressure buildup is always a concern beneath concrete structures, so this project includes drilled weep holes through the set concrete to relieve that pressure. And here we see the full extent of the project. More than 1 million square feet of GEOWEB and saved the railroad a significant amount of money and installation time. To activate our in-house engineering team to see how we can help value engineer for your project, visit prestogeo.com. If global stability is a concern, or if steeper than 65 degree face is required, embankments should be built as a retaining wall. The GEOWEB panels can be stacked vertically on top of one another to create a gravity retaining wall, and GeoGrid tieback reinforcements can be added as necessary, similar to MSC block or gabion basket walls. The walls can be filled with topsoil in the front cell to create living green walls and can be built to support vehicle or building loading. Here are the two different wall options in cross-section. Gravity, with longer pieces of web at the bottom and shorter as you go up, the weight of the infill GEOWEB is what provides the retention. Or the GeoGrid reinforced walls, with the GeoGrid providing the retention and GEOWEB functioning as a fascia alternative. In either case, again, the front cells can be filled with topsoil and the back cells or reinforced zone can use any drainable material. Here's an example of an Ohio DOT project where the 20-foot-high wall was constructed to keep the rock face from eroding further. The GEOWEB system is the fascia that helps to protect the road without taking up a lot of horizontal space. Now on to our last topic for today. Using the GEOWEB system for stormwater control in place of typical stormwater infrastructure along roadways. The GEOWEB channel protection system is very similar to the slope protection system, covering entire channels or just single embankments. Continuous or immediate flow, low to high flow, and a variety of channel dimensions are possible with the GEOWEB system. This system is more economical than solutions that utilize large riprap stone or heavy gabion baskets, and several different infill material options are available to meet any channel flow needs. The GEOWEB system can be placed along the embankments of stormwater channels to help prevent erosion due to fluctuating water levels. Low flow situations are easily handled by vegetated GEOWEB systems, creating natural looking embankments without intensive maintenance requirements. The GEOWEB system does not need to cover the bottom of the channel if continuous low flow water is present. The type of vegetation within the GEOWEB panel is not important to the function of the system. So choosing plants that are native to the area and okay with the occasional soaking will be a big help in reducing potential maintenance. The vegetated GEOWEB system has a lower cost than a riprap line channel, since you can use local topsoil and won't need to import large stone. There's also less maintenance, since riprap channels need constant inspection to replace lost stone and remove weeds. With a vegetated channel, the only maintenance is the occasional mowing, which can be done with your standard mowing equipment, no special equipment needed. And finally, vegetated channels have better aesthetics than riprap channels. Extensive research was performed at Colorado State University to show how the vegetated GEOWEB system can perform in channel conditions compared to riprap. What we determined was that when paired with a turf reinforcement mat or TRM, the GEOWEB and TRM system can resist extremely high flows, allowing velocities of around 30 feet per second and high shear stresses for a vegetated channel. We also tested aggregate channels with three different cell sizes and two different rock sizes and over 90 tests allowing for regression analysis. This equation allows us to perform a rock loss analysis. Given the bed slope and unit discharge of a particular channel, we can manipulate rock size and cell size until rock loss, or L, equals zero. When compared to traditional riprap sizing tools by Abbotts & Johnson or the Army Corps of Engineers, GEOWEB channels can reduce rock size from 2 to 10 times. This large variance is due to bed slope. We can reduce rock size more on flatter bed slopes. And finally, concrete-filled channels. Studies by the U.S. Bureau of Reclamation show concrete-filled GEOWEB to be the most cost-effective, lowest-maintenance solution for water conveyance channels, like this example of GEOWEB over a geomembrane water conveyance channel in Colorado. This project carries water from the Colorado Mountains over 900 miles to agricultural fields in California and Utah. Once GEOWEB is installed, it performs the role of concrete formwork. Here, concrete is pumped into the cells. It can also be poured directly from concrete trucks if access allows. Screed and finish to the top of the cells. And notice the flexibility of the system. It won't crack like poured in place concrete. And requires no expansion joints, which can become a weak point over time. Again, very impressive results for the concrete filled version of the system with the CSU testing. And now some examples. This stormwater channel project in Florida shows how the GEOWEB retaining wall system can be used in water flow and wet environments as well. The stack system can be used in urban areas where there's no room to lay back side slopes or in order to handle more volume in the same footprint. Great for along roads and highways. Vegetation can be used above the waterline for a more natural look, with concrete used below the waterline to help resist erosion or washout. The GEOWEB system can also be used in conjunction with riprap when there's the potential for very high flows, such as this culvert outfall in Milwaukee. Stronger surface protection with their panels, such as TRM or core fabric, can be used to withstand high flow events. This is intended for short duration events rather than high continuous flow. The flexible GEOWEB panels can easily accommodate culvert pipes or other obstacles, so there are no gaps in protection. And including sonotubes allows for the addition of guardrail posts. We often hear from contractors how easy it is to install the GEOWEB system, even if they've never worked with it before, and how it goes into place much faster and easier than gabion baskets or H-pile walls. We have written installation guides and tutorial videos on our website, as well as providing on-site or personalized assistance when required. Check out prestogeo.com for additional channel resources. In summary, every project is different, but the GEOWEB system has a solution that's right for your project needs. GEOWEB can be added to road projects to provide a more stable and longer lasting surface course for unpaved areas, which will reduce maintenance and repairs. For paved surfaces, GEOWEB decreases pressure on the subgrade to reduce differential and long-term settlement, which will extend your pavement life. The ability to use low-quality aggregate or even sand can save a significant amount of money. Whether you're looking to stabilize your roadway, protect your embankments, or manage your stormwater runoff, the GEOWEB system has great flexibility of design to meet your project needs. It's a complete system solution for ease of installation and peace of mind. Part of our complete solution is our technical assistance. The engineering team here at Presto Geosystems works closely with landscape designers and engineers, offering a free project evaluation service for any roads, embankment, or erosion control project. The form is on our website, prestogeo.com. You fill it out with as much information as you have, including attaching documents such as geotechnical reports, project site pictures, or other info, and it comes directly to us. Then, usually within 3 business days, our in-house design engineering team will provide a complete design evaluation, including infill recommendations and anchorage requirements. We'll work with you to get the very best design for your project needs. We deliver quality and over 40 years of expertise, guaranteeing that each shipment meets or exceeds our specs, so you can deliver certainty and build with materials you can trust. No disclaimers or concerning fine print. We're now making it faster and easier for you to obtain your PDH certificates. With our webinar dashboard, you can easily view your webinars and download PDH certificates for on-demand and live webinars attended. Your webinar dashboard will keep a record of all on-demand webinars completed, along with PDH credits earned. A link with more information and instructional videos is going to be emailed to you, and those of you who are in attendance today will automatically receive a PDH certificate within the next 24 hours. Note that this comes from GoToWebinar and not from Presto, so be on the lookout for it depending on your company's cybersecurity setup. You may need to check your spam folder at the end of the week if you've not yet received your certificate. And that's the presentation. I want to thank you for attending and remind you that you can send questions to us at any time at info@prestogeo.com. Go to prestogeo.com for a wealth of information. And don't forget to view our YouTube videos found by clicking on the YouTube icon in the upper right corner of our webpage. I'll answer questions next, but if you have a question I don't get to, you can respond to the follow-up email and we'll be happy to answer your questions and help with any project recommendations. Thank you again for joining us today. Now on to our questions. There were a couple of comments about lost audio. This presentation has been recorded and a link to that recording will be sent to you. You can also come back and see it as an on-demand and catch the part you missed. There are a couple of questions asking about commercial representatives or distributors from certain area, as well as cost estimates. We'll follow up with those via email and help connect you with our local representative. A question on how to infill on very steep slopes. Typically, from top down is the recommendation, but on the example, the extreme example shown on the Pan American Highway and about 75 degree slope angle, those had to be hand infilled, and it was kind of a very careful and long process, but it allowed for extreme slope angles to be vegetated and safe over time. Oftentimes, infill can be loaded with a rock slinger, for example, or a bucket. Again, if you have a particular project in mind, our in-house team, technical team, is happy to help you through it. You can also see some videos of our infill process. Visit the YouTube portion at prestogeo.com. Next question, do we have any historical after photos from a lengthier period, especially on embankments? We do, actually. One that comes to mind is a landfill. They had over 9 meters of differential settlement over the first 15 years and a vertical drop of about 160 meters. And that was a GEOWEB channel with dissipators, energy dissipators. And we have the initial installation pictures, as well as the 15-year follow-up pictures. And many of our projects, although we don't have a formal case study for it, we have the before, during, after, and revisit pictures. Another one that comes to mind is the high steel intermodal yard, 10 years of very heavy loading on porous pavement, and GEOWEB still performing perfectly. So if you'd like to see a particular example, again, respond in the follow-up email, and we're happy to share additional resources. Next question, should tree growth be controlled on GEOWEB stabilized embankments? Many landscape architects ask us if we can incorporate specific types of trees. And yes, we can plan for select and decorative plantings, including mature growth plantings if needed. In this case, you wouldn't necessarily have to do anything special for tree growth. As vegetation develops and matures, including trees and shrubs, that root zone interlock will further stabilize the slope. For near vertical walls, how far will the stone infill need to be placed from the face, from the wall face? For near vertical walls, you'd want to fill the cells completely, of course. If it's vegetated, you need a setback to allow the vegetation to remain. Again, we'd be happy to work with you on your particular project and answer design questions particular to your site needs. If aggregate is used on a road without other surfaces, how much loss can be expected? Typically, even if there's an overfill beyond the GEOWEB system or a wear surface, you won't see the rutting and pushing and loss as you would in a non-stabilized or non-contained system. So although you could plan for maintenance over time, it's much less than you would typically, than you'd see in typical other structures. Again, reach out to our technical team if you have a specific cross-section in mind, and we'd be happy to do a value engineering comparison for you. That will be our last question today. We're already over time, but if I didn't get to your question, please respond directly to that follow-up email, and our team will be in touch and provide additional resources. Thank you again for attending, and be well.